Hello friends, welcome back. My name is PK. In this video, you will learn how to create an automated attendance sheet in Microsoft Excel. As you are seeing my screen, I have created this automated attendance sheet. I have multiple sheets here, so let me show you first attendance sheet. So just click on this button to see the attendance sheet. So this is the attendance sheet wherein you can select your month. So this is for Jan 2020. And here you can see the employee ID, employee name, supervisor, and the present count, absent count, and leave count. And here we have the different dates from 1st to 31st and the attendance like absent, present, or leave. We have highlighted Saturday and Sunday here as week off, so it is highlighted in dark color. Then on top we have given total present in the month, absent and leave. You can change the month from here to see the attendance for different months. So let's say Feb 2020. As soon as I will select this, automatically it will show me the attendance for Feb 2020. And you can see here the date is now from 1st to 29th only. And similarly we can see for the March 2020 also. So again, the attendance has been changed and now it is displaying for the March 2020. If I will select, let's say April 2020, then as of now it is blank because we have not marked any attendance for April 2020. Now I'll show you how can you mark the attendance. So let's go to the back and it will take you to the index page, and from here you can mark the attendance. So just click here on mark attendance, and here we have the different employee name. If you want to get the latest data from the employee master, you can simply click on refresh. It will show the latest employee list from the employee master. Here you can mark the attendance for one day or multiple days. So you can mark 7 days attendance at a time. Let me mark the attendance for 1st April . Alright, you can mark for the multiple dates also. Similarly, you can mark the attendance for the other day. You can change the date from here. So let's take 1st May. You can mark the attendance for the 1st May. Whatever date you will put on the top, the attendance will be marked for those days. Now here you can see we have one checkbox, that is update data when already exist. So let's say if you have already marked the attendance for 1st April. Then if you will try to mark the attendance again, and if you have checked this checkbox, then what will happen? It will update the existing attendance. For example, let's say for first employee, you have marked the attendance on 1st April as present. Now you are marking as absent, then it will overwrite the existing attendance. So if you don't want to overwrite, you can uncheck this, then it will skip this because you have already marked the attendance for this day. Alright, so let me check this, and now I'll click on mark attendance. So you can see here attendance has been marked. Now we can click on back and we can see again the attendance sheet. Now here in attendance sheet you can see for the April month we have the data for 1st of April, and whatever attendance we have marked there is available here. Alright friends. So that's how you can mark the attendance. Now I'll show you how can you maintain your employee master. Just click here and you can add the employee from here, or you can edit the information, employee ID, employee name and supervisor from here. And just click on the back button. Now I'll show you the database wherein the attendance is being marked. So we have another worksheet here, which is the database sheet. We have created a unique ID here. Then we have employee ID, name, supervisor, date and attendance. You don't need to do anything manually here. Data is being updated automatically here when you are clicking on mark attendance button from the mark attendance sheet. Recently we have marked the attendance for the 1st April. You can see it is available here. Now let me click on the back button. I'll show you the setting sheet also. In the setting sheet you can change the attendance code. So this is the attendance list or the attendance codes here. PALWOBCOF, and we have given here the month list. So as soon as new month you want to add, you can add the first date of the month. Simply copy and paste here, and you can put here 5, then it will display May 2020. And when you will go back and attendance sheet, then you will see in the drop-down May 2020. So that's how you can maintain this drop-down list. Now I'll show you the second thing. Go to the setting sheet. Here we have given the highlight Saturday and Sunday. So you can highlight any 2 days which could be your week offs. So, or if you don't want to give any fixed week off, you can simply delete this. Then if I will go back and attendance sheet, then my day will not be highlighted. So let me show you once again. If I will keep here, let's say Monday, I want to highlight the Monday, then I'll click on back and I'll go to the attendance sheet. Then every Monday will be highlighted in this dark color. You can see it here. Friends, that's how we can mark the attendance and we can use this template. Now I will tell you step by step how can you create this beautiful template in Microsoft Excel. Please watch this video till the end. I'll cover all the points in this video. So let's start without delay. First of all, I'm going to make visible the sheet tabs so that you can see all the sheet tabs. To do that, you can go to the Excel option using Alt+T+O. And then you can go to the advanced, and from here you can go to the show sheet tabs here, display option for this workbook. You can just check this and click on OK. The sheet tabs will be visible. I'll tell you another option. You can use the PK's utility tool version 2.0, and here I have given this show hide sheet tab button. You can just click here, then you can see sheet tabs are visible. If you will click again, then sheet tabs will be invisible. You can download this utility tool from my website. I have given the download link in video description box. This tool is absolutely free. Alright, so let me click on show hide sheet tabs. Now here you can see we have 6 different sheet tabs. The first one is the index, wherein we have put this multiple buttons. And next is the mark attendance, is this one. When I will click here, it will take you to the mark attendance. From here, you can mark the attendance. Then we have the employee master, we have the database, and then we have the attendance sheet, then we have setting sheet. So let's go to the employee master first. We have this employee master sheet. Let's copy this data and press Ctrl N to add a new workbook and just paste this data here. So we have the employee list here, and let's rename this as employee master. Alright, now we have the employee master. Now let's create another sheet here, which will be our database. In the database, first we will keep the unique ID to use the VLOOKUP. Then we will take this information, employee ID, name and supervisor. So let's paste this here. Then we need date. And in the last, we need attendance. And then we will add here setting sheet. In the setting sheet, we can take first attendance code or attendance list, whatever you want to say. In the attendance list, let's say we are taking P for present, A for absent, and L for leave, and we can take WO for BCom. Then here we can take the month list. Let's take 1st Jan. We are taking the first date of the month, and we can take, let's say, 1st Feb. For now, I'm just keeping these two. You can add more. So we can select the entire column, right click, go to the format cells. Then we can go to the number custom, and here we can put the format as MMM-YY. Then here we can take the highlight days. In the highlight, we can take Sunday and Saturday. So we will connect our formula with these two cells. Whatever day will be available in these two cells, that will be highlighted on attendance sheet. Now let's move on to the attendance sheet. We are going to create the attendance sheet. Let me save this file as macro enable, because we will add few macros also for using the mark attendance. So let's save it. Just press F12. I'm keeping the name as book 1 only for now, and make sure you have selected macro enabled workbook. We can use this employee master actually, just copy and just paste this here, and we can see in this file also we have taken it from A5. So let's take it from A5. We can insert one more. Go to the view and enable the headings so that it will be visible. We have taken already employee ID, name, supervisor. Then we can take present, absent and leave. Let's put here Now we can put the dates. So before putting the dates, we have taken the month here, you can see, and it is coming from the drop down. So we can type here month, and first let me create the dynamic range. And to create the dynamic list, we will use the offset function. So let me show you first offset function here. If I will use offset and I'm giving this reference and just freezing this reference, pressing F4, comma, we don't want to give the row and column, so I'll skip this using comma. So basically I'll put three commas, then I'll use the height and width. For getting the height, I'll use count A, and I'll get the count of all text available here. Then because we are taking the count of headers also, I have to use here -1. And for width, we are taking only one column, so I'll use here one only, and just press enter. Now you can see it is giving me the complete list. So what we can do, we can use the similar formula in NAM manager. So just delete this, select A1, then I'll go to the formulas and I'll go to the NAM manager. I'll click on new name, and here I will use the formula offset. So I'll use equal to offset, and then I'll click on A2 comma. I'll put two more commas to skip the row and columns. For height, I'll use count A, and I'll give this reference -1 comma. I'll use here 1, and just close the bracket. Click on OK. Now I'll add one more new, and here I will use for month. In the month, I'll use similar formula offset, but this time I will take this range, 3 commas, count A, and I'll take this reference -1 comma 1, and just close the bracket and close. So we have created two names. Now I'll go to the attendance sheet, and here I'll use the data validation in this cell. Let me highlight this in different colors. So let's say I'm highlighting in this color. Go to the data, and then you can go to the validation. So here this is the data validation, and just click on data validation. I'll select here list, and then I will type here name as month. So we have given the name as month, or you can press F3. Then this paste name window will be popped up, and here you can select, we have created two names, so you can select here month. Click on OK. Now if I will select, you can see I'm getting the month, but here after selecting the month, it is not giving the proper value. So what we can do, we can change the formatting here also. So just right click, go to the format cells, custom, and again here you can put MMM-YYYY. Click on OK. So we have proper month here. And if I want to add new month in the list, we have only 2 months, Jan and Feb. So I'll go to the settings sheet. I'll add here 1st March 2020. So the March 2020 will be added. As soon as I will come to the attendance sheet, new month will be visible here in this drop down. Alright friends, now we will add dates here. So the first date we will take whatever month has been selected. So we can put here equal to, and just press enter. Now I will change the format of this. So I'll use Alt OE, or right click, go to the format cells, and here we will take format as DD. So we will take only dates. So this is the first date. Now I'll use here equal to this plus 1, and we will move this right side till 31st, because last date of the month could be 31st. Alright, so we have taken till 31st. Now I'll select these columns, select entire columns, double click here to auto fit the columns. Alright, so we have the date from 1st to 31st. But what if I will select here Feb? Then in Feb 2020, we have only 29 days, then here it is giving 1 and 2. It should display the data till end of the month. It should not display these two dates. So we can put a formula here. That formula will be if, and I'll take here day of this date is less than or equal to 3, then it will display blank, else it will display this. and just copy this formula, press enter. And then here we will paste the same formula, but this time we will take a H, which is this 28 plus 2, and here again we will use plus 2 and press enter. So you can see it is giving some name error. Okay, we have not taken if properly, press enter. So it is blank now. And now let me paste this formula here. Put here I for the if. This time I will take 3 and 3 and press enter. Now automatically you can see it is taking blank. If I will select here March, then it is taking day here. Alright friends, so in the Feb, automatically it will hide those days, in the March it will show. Let's select this range and go to the conditional formatting and add new rule, or you can click on manage rule. Or to open the manage rule, you can press Alt O D. This manage rule window will be opened. We don't have any rule as of now, so let's click on new rule. And in the new rule, we can simply go to the format only cells that contains, and here we will put on no blanks. When there is no blank, then only this format should apply. Go to the format and let's go to the fill. You can fill any color, so I'm taking, let's say, this blue color. Font we can take white and make this bold. Click on okay. So here you can see it is giving blue color till this column, which is AK. But as soon as I will select Fab, then it is not giving the background color for AJ and AK. Now we will put some other formulas from the employee master. So I'll use here if, then I'll go to the employee master. I'll take the first reference. If this value equal to blank, then it will display blank, else it will display this. Press enter. I will copy the same formula till the, let's say, 100 rows. So that when you have long list of the employee, it will be available here. Or you can add more formulas whenever it is required. So we are getting all the employee from the employee master. As soon as I will add a new employee here, let's say 100016, employee name is test, let's say PK. Then I'll go to the attendance sheet. Automatically that employee is coming here. Alright, so let's delete this. And now here we will take the count of percent. So we can simply use count if. We will take the reference till here, because sometime date could be till 31st. P here. Just close the bracket, press enter. And we'll use the similar formula for the absence. So just copy and paste here. For leave also paste. The only difference in place of P, we will take here A. In place of P, we will take here L. Alright, so just fill this down. Now we will use few formulas here to get the value from the database. Alright, so before getting the value from the database, what we will do? We will put some dummy data here so that we can see whether it is working properly or not. So what I will do, I'll go to this sheet and let's copy this all data and let's paste this here. Now we have the data for Jan, Feb and March. So let me show you. We have Jan, Feb and March and April also. So let's go to the attendance sheet, and here we will use a key with employee ID and date. So if you will see in the database, we have a unique ID, which is employee ID underscore and date. So this is the unique ID, employee ID first underscore, then we have date. So same thing we will use here. We'll use here VLOOKUP, then lookup value, we will create the lookup value. So lookup value will be employee ID and underscore and date. So date will be this date. Alright, comma. Then I'll go to the database and here I'll select this table array. And we will pick up the value from column number 6, which is column number F. So I'll take here comma 6 comma 0 and just close the bracket, press enter. We are not getting any value. So let's see. Because we don't have any data for first Feb. And the reason is it could be week off. So we have not marked any attendance for week off. So let's go to the attendance sheet. And here, first of all, we will freeze here this column. So put the dollar sign before A. And in G5, we will freeze row number. So put the dollar sign before 5. And we will freeze this range also. So just select and press F4 and press enter. And now we will use here if error. If error, then it will display blank. Close the bracket, press enter. Now I will copy this formula and I'll go to till here and then I'll go here and I will paste everywhere this formula till this range, paste here. Alright, now if I will come to the top, you can see automatically it is displaying me the attendance. So basically these two could be week off, which is Saturday and Sunday, and rest is being highlighted. If I will change the month, then I will see, yes, it is working and the attendance is displaying here properly. Now let me go to the view and just remove the grid lines from here. Now it is properly visible. Now we will fill down these formulas also. And we can put some conditional formatting here. Press Alt-OD to open the rule manager. Click on new rule. Just go to the use a formula to determine which cell to format. And here we will use if this value, and here we'll remove the dollar sign from row number because row will be changed when the formula will go down. So I'll use if this cell is equal to blank, then go to the format, go to the number format, custom format. Here I'll put thrice semicolon. Then our zero will not be visible. Apply, okay. You can see now it is not visible. Alright, now we will put few other conditional formatting also. So first of all, let's select this all and now I'll use here Alt-OD, new rule, use a formula to determine which cell to format, and here we will use end. First of all, this cell, I will remove the dollar sign from here. So this cell is not equal to blank, comma, and this cell, the header, I'll remove the dollar sign before A, is not equal to blank. Then we will put some border. So I'll go to the border. Let's take this gray color, this line, and this outline. Click on OK. OK. Apply. You can see some border also. Alright, change the font size little bit smaller. Now we will highlight the Saturday and Sunday. So I'll select this range, Alt OD, new rule, then go to the use a formula to determine which cell to format, and here I will use or, and I'll use text function and start bracket. I'll take this range and from here I'll remove the dollar sign from the column and I'll use here DDDD. So basically I'm fetching the day name from this date is equal to, I'll go to the setting sheet and I'll select this range. If it is this value, or I'll copy the same formula, comma, the second condition I'll take E3, which is Saturday. So whatever day you have put here, if it is from that, then you can go to the format and go to the fill. We can fill some gray color like this. Okay, apply. Okay. So here you can see it is highlighted, but it is taking till the bottom. So what we can do, we can put another condition here. Select this range, Alt OD. In the same, I'll put AND function here, AND. And the first thing, I'll take this cell and from here, I'll remove the dollar sign from the row number. If this is not equal to blank, comma, the second condition will be this OR condition. And in the last, I will close the bracket. Let me show you this formula once again. We are using first AND. Then A6, putting the dollar sign before A, is not equal to blank, and then we are putting the same OR function. Click on OK. Now you can see it is highlighting till here only. Alright, this is one of the conditional formatting we have put here. Now I'll select again this range and press Alt-OD, and we will put few other conditional formatting, new rule, format only cells that contains, and we'll take equal to, put here P. For P, we want to highlight in, let's say, green, light green color. You can take font as white if you want to take. Okay. New rule, this time we can take equal to, let's say for absent, we want to highlight in dark red color. So let's take font white, fill this dark red color. Okay, new rule. And we can take this time for leaf equal to L format. So let's highlight this blue, font take white. So click on apply. Alright, so it will look like this. Now, you can see the border is not visible properly. So what we can do, we can press Alt OD. This particular rule, which is for border, we can move to the top. Or if you want to change the color for this little darker so that it will be visible properly. Alright, so now border is visible properly. We can see here. On the top we can display, so let's create some boxes here like this and like this. So here we can fill this green color, here we can fill this dark red color, and here we can fill this blue color. Font we can take white and here white. So here we can use some of the present, so let's take the sum of this, press enter. So we are getting the sum. Make this bold, slightly bigger. Here you can type present, merge this. Same you can do here. This is for absent, copy, and this is for leave. You can use the similar formula here. You can copy this actually. Format also will come here. Paste and paste. We can change the color again. And here let's take dark. Change the reference from the absent. And for this one, we will take the reference from leave. Alright. So if I will change the month from here, then you can see the attendance is getting changed. Now we'll create another seat, and that seat will be mark attendance. So for now we have just displayed the attendance which is already marked in database. Now I will tell you how can you mark the attendance using this seat, and we can protect this worksheet. So you can simply protect all the cells other than this particular cell which I have selected, because you have to change the values here. Select this range, press Alt OE or right click, go to the format cells and go to the protection. And here you can see this cell is locked. Just unlock this, click on OK. Now you can press Alt TPP or you can go to the review and click on protect seat. You can put any password, but I am not putting any password, click on OK. Now you won't be able to edit anything, but you can change this month because this is not protected. Alright, so it's working properly. Now, we have displayed the attendance here, whatever we have already marked in database. So, now I will tell you how can you mark the attendance in database using this mark attendance form. So, here what we will do, like here we have created the mark attendance, this one. The similar view we will create there. So, let's go to the employee master and let's copy this one from here. You can copy all the employees and let's paste on this mark attendance sheet from here. And now here we will put a date. So let's say I'm taking 1st April. You can take any date, and user will change this date as per the requirement. You can add few other dates so that user can mark the attendance for multiple dates. So I'm putting here +1 and let's take at least 7 days so that user can mark the attendance for 7 days at least on one click. You can highlight this in another color if you want, or in the same color. Okay. Now we have given two buttons here. The first button is refresh button and mark attendance, as well as we have given this update data when already exists. So let me go to the developer tab and insert, and I'll go to the form controls. I'll take this checkbox and just click here, and in this checkbox I have put right click, go to the format control, and I'll go to the control, cell link, let's click on D1. Now, if I will check this, then true will be available on D1. If I will uncheck, false will be available. You can go to the home and make the white font so that it will not be visible. So here I have taken white color. Alright, now I'll go to the insert and I'll go to the insert saves and I'll take, let's say, this rectangle, or you can take from here and create the first rectangle. That will be for refresh. Right click, edit text, and type here refresh. Go to the home, align center, center. You can go to the save format. You can take any formatting from here. Let's take this one, or let's take. Go to the view and uncheck the grid lines from here. Now here we can create a drop down. That's put the border, then press Alt DL to open the data validation and go to the list, and here we will press F3 to open the paste name window, and we will select this name which we have created already for attendance list or attendance course. Click on OK. So we can see here the list of the attendance, whatever you want to mark. Alright, now we will create two macros. First macro we will assign to refresh button, second macro we will assign to mark attendance. So let's go to the developer tab and Visual Basic. These are two macros which I have already created for the seat 1. So I'll copy these two and I will paste in new module in book 1. So I'll go to the insert and module and I will paste this here. I will explain you step by step. First, we have created for refresh data. So we have taken two variables. First one is SH as worksheet and then MSH as worksheet. We have assigned them as mark attendance and employee master worksheet. Then first of all, SH, which is for the mark attendance. So what we are doing, we are clearing the data from A4 to C and till the last row. So let's go to here in this seat. Mark attendance. So we are clearing the data from A4 till end. Then what we are doing here, we are copying the data from the employee master. So you can see we are copying from A2. So let me go to the employee master, this one. We are copying the data from here till the end, column C. So copying all the data and then pasting on mark attendance A4. So basically what we are doing, we are updating the data again from the employee master. If there is any change in the list, it will give you the latest list of the employees from the employee master. So this is the refresh data. Right click and right click on the refresh button, assign macro, and just select this workbook and we will select this refresh data. If I will click, then you can see it is saying data has been refreshed. Alright. Now I'll show you the mark attendance also. In the mark attendance, we have taken again two variables, SH and DSH for the worksheet. SH we have taken for the mark attendance sheet and DSH we have taken for the database sheet. We have taken two integer variables also, R and C, and we have taken LR as long integer. Now here you can see I have put two loops. The first for loop I have put for C, C I have taken for the columns, and R I have taken for the rows. The first loop is saying C equal to 4 to 10. So I'll tell you, I'm putting the loop here. This is column number 4 and this is column number 10. So from column number 4 to column number 10, I'm running the loop. You might have put your attendance in all the dates. Then we are running the loop in the rows. So loop we are running in the rows is R equal to 4. So 4 we are taking this row number 4 till the end of the row. So we are using sh.a and application.rows.count.endxlf.row. So whatever is the last row, we are running the loop from here. So first we are going in the first column, which is column number 4. Then we are running the loop till here. We will mark the attendance for first date. Then we'll move to the second date, we'll mark the attendance for the second date, then third and fourth and till the seventh date. Alright, so this is what we are going to do. Now, first of all, we are checking, make sure the attendance code is available here. So we are using the sh.cells R and C. Means if we are going to mark the attendance, let's say for this employee for this date, then it should not be blank. Something should be available here. Then only the attendance will be marked. So It is checking if it is not blank, then it will move further. Then here we are checking, you can see application.worksheet function.countif, and we are taking here ESH, which is the database seed A2A. So let me show you the database A2A. This is the unique ID. So basically we are going to check, say for this employee we are going to mark the attendance for 1st April. Might be possible we have already marked the attendance for this employee for 1st April. So we are checking if we have already marked or not. So we are creating this unique ID here, you can see. If the count is coming greater than 0, that means we have already marked. So if we have already marked, then we will check if D1 value is equal to true. D1 means the value is coming here. So let me change the color. If it is true, that means we have checked if attendance is already marked, then update the latest attendance. So in this case, what we are going to do, we are assigning the LR, the last row or the row on which we are going to mark the attendance, using the match function. So we are finding that particular row and we are putting these values on that particular row. So we are putting on A and that row, this is unique ID, then this is the employee code, employee name, supervisor name, then this will be the date and this will be the attendance. Date we are taking from row number 3 and column number C. So row number 3 is the date, column will be dynamic. Alright, so this is the case wherein we want to update the attendance. And if this count is not greater than 0, that means that attendance is not already marked. In that case, the LR will be, the row number will be the last row. So we are using the count A function to get the count using the plus 1 here. Then we are using the same thing. So now this time data will be updated at the bottom of the database, not in between. Alright, so that's how we will update the data in the database. Then here at the bottom we have put the message as attendance has been marked. Now I'll go to the mark attendance, right click, assign macro, and I'll select mark attendance. Now let's say if I will mark the attendance for 2nd April. So let me go to the attendance sheet first. Let's select here April. So April is not available here. So I'll go to the setting sheet. I'll use here 1st April. Now I'll go to the attendance sheet and I'll select here April. So here you can see the data is available only for 1st April. So there is no data available for the 2nd April. So what I will do, I'll go to the mark attendance, and for few employees I'll mark the attendance. Let's say these 3 employees, I want to mark the attendance for 2nd April. So I'll click on mark attendance. Attendance has been marked. Now I'll go to the attendance sheet. I will see the same here. Alright, so it is available here. So friends, that's how you can use this template and you can create this template. Now you can create a new sheet here. You can put the name as index, and then you can create your buttons using insert, and let's take this here. So let's create the first one as mark attendance. Format, let's take any format. So I'm taking, let's say, this one. I'm quickly making the other buttons copy and paste. We have created 5 different buttons here, and now we can go to the view and remove the grid lines, select all the buttons, go to the save format, align them left, distribute them vertically, put this here, select these columns, entire column, right click, hide the column. Similarly, we can select the rows from here, entire rows, right click, hide the rows. So we have only these buttons here. Now we can create the hyperlink. So right click, go to the link and just click on insert link, or you can select the button, press Ctrl K, then insert hyperlink window will be opened, and select place in this document. This is for the mark attendance, so you can select the mark attendance, and similarly for the other one, select and press Ctrl K. This is for attendance sheet. If I will click on mark attendance, it will take me to the mark attendance page. And here you can create another button, which will be for the back button. You can insert any image or icon. Let's create the simple arrow button. Let's take this back arrow, right click, and you can put here back. You can change the color, whatever you want to take. So let's take this color and select this back button, Ctrl K, and you can select this index. Now, if I will click, it will take me to this. So what we can do, copy this back button and put everywhere and just paste this here. You can keep this here. In the setting sheet, you can keep this here. You can remove the grid lines from the setting sheet if you want. You can put this in the database also. Here you can see we have marked the attendance for these three employees, so it is available here. You can put it on the top. Similarly in the employee master also. Now, anywhere you will click on the back, you can just use this index. And now you can hide the sheet tabs using PKC utility tool. Click on hide sheet tabs. So now you need to use this navigation to go to any of the sheet. Alright friends, so friends, that's how you can create this automated attendance sheet. You can use it as a template in your process and you can start marking the attendance in this Excel sheet. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Friends, if you like this video, please hit the like button and please subscribe my channel to get the regular update of my videos. Thank you so much for watching.